guys, what's up and welcome to 2020.
I cannot believe it is already the year 2020, and I feel like every single year everyone's always like,
oh my god, I can't believe the year went by so fast.
But truthfully, I do think this year just flew by. I was just in college and now I am more than 6 months out working my real job and everything, and so it's crazy. I did set it up, my tripod on my bed, and so now we have a different backdrop than my normal windowsill, but my window's right here, so if the lighting looks wonky, I'm gonna have to see it post, but hopefully this is okay and you guys don't hate me. Anyway, I wanted to make this video, even though it's after the new year, it's only the third, so I figured this is still relevant to go up. But I wanted to just do a little reflection of 2019 and sort of set some goals that I have for 2020. I feel like this is just really good to do, just for me to look back on, honestly, and see how the years went. And also just to sort of set goals for the new year and to hopefully accomplish some of them. Personally, I'm not a huge person to set like resolutions where it's like you have to go to the gym like 5 times a day, like you have to cut this and that out of your diet. Like, I'm not one of those people. If you're one of those people and that strategy works for you, that's amazing. But personally for me, that kind of strictness doesn't really work, and I end up just giving it up, and it just, I'd be like, all right, I messed up one day, what's the point of continuing? For me, I'm someone where I like to set more sort of realistic goals for the year, just things that I want to do, and hopefully I end up doing them. I think it's just good to sort of, I feel like a new year is a great time to just sort of reset, reflect, and to set new goals for the year. I feel like it's a good time to sort of step back and see where you are, who you are as a person, because I know for sure I've changed since like this past summer itself. So let's get into this video. First things first, to reflect on 2019. I'm not gonna lie, 2019 was a really hard year for me, and if you're watching this, you follow me on social media, you might be extremely confused. In 2019, I graduated college, I got my bachelor's in business, I graduated as a finance major from Temple University. So I graduated, I landed my first full-time job, and I got to move to the city of my dreams. You guys know I live here in New York City now, which has been a dream of mine since childhood. I've always wanted to move to New York, and so I got to do all of those things, which I am very proud of, and I'm very happy that that's something that I, you know, got to do. But it's like, despite all of those things, I think I have dealt with so many personal issues this entire year, which I haven't really spoken to anybody about. I mean, other than my family, but I feel like this has just been a really, really rough year for me. And I feel like it's the year where I cried a lot by myself. I feel like I felt very lonely. I felt very lost. I felt very confused, very hurt. Just a lot of different emotions that, you know, even though it was like, you graduated college and you got to move to New York City, it was like I had all of these other things that were sort of going on that deterred that sort of surface. And so that's kind of my quick recap of 2019. I feel like there were those good things that happened, but personally I felt like a huge weight was just weighing me down, and I definitely did not feel my best in 2019. So moving aside, let's step into 2020 and talk about that. For 2020, some of the things that I want to achieve, I was doing this whole reflection of things that I love to do when I initially started this challenge, because started this channel because of entrepreneurship and startup life and everything, which is something I'm still so passionate about. But last year I got to be in an indie film, and I got to watch a documentary that I was in. I did a couple photo shoots, and it just sort of reminded me of what I truly, truly, truly love to do, and that's act and create. And so one of my biggest goals for this year, and I don't know if you guys know this, but I am signed to a talent agency, and I can make a whole other video about how challenging it is to be a person of color, especially Indian. For me, what I've realized, I feel the happiest when I am on set, when I am creating cool things with people who are all just committed to that. And I don't care how many hours go into it, I can be there all day, all night, all week, it doesn't matter. I literally, the hours just fly by for me, and it's something I truthfully love to do. So one of my goals this year is to act more, perform more, create more content, because I love doing this. I love my Fridays because I can sit down and literally just talk to a camera and I feel so comfortable in it. Now that I have my Fridays, I truthfully, I know I say this every single time, but I genuinely want to make videos every single week. Now I'm starting to work from home on Tuesdays as well, so now I want to see if I can do 2 days a week. I love doing this, and I hope that you guys are enjoying the content as well, but I love YouTube and I love making videos. I love, you know, shooting things on the side. It just fuels me, it keeps me creative, it keeps me going, and it's something that I truthfully love to do. So that is a huge goal of mine. The second is I want to sing more. I'll kind of post covers here and there on my Instagram if you guys follow me, but I haven't like sat in a studio and actually recorded and done that, or like performed at an open mic and stuff. And it's something that I want to put pressure on myself to do. It's something that people have told me. They've said, you know, I've been asked, you know, if I'm in a band, if I write, if I record, like I should totally put out music. And it's something that I'm always like, I should do it, I should do it. And in the back of my mind, I was always like, I'm not good enough. There's no point. Like, there's so many people that are better than me. But I realized like that I love to do it. And if even a handful of people have told me I should do it, I probably should. And so I've just kind of been writing, and you know, like I said, 2019 was rough, and I think that music was sort of the one thing that really grounded me and was able to kind of capture all the emotions I was feeling. And I feel like that's something so powerful with music, that words and people just don't, they can't feel that emotional capacity that music can. So hopefully I get to record and make great music this year. That's just something I've always loved to do and something that I hope I can do for this year. Third, I maintain a pretty healthy lifestyle. Like, I eat healthy, I'm pretty good at going to the gym, I live up a fifth floor walk up, so I feel like that's a workout in of itself. But I think I just want to kind of maintain living a healthy lifestyle. I don't know if that's really a goal, because it's something I kind of do and I've done over the years. But it feels great and I feel great, and I think it's just good to practice that healthy lifestyle. So I want to make sure I'm continuing to go to the gym, continuing to eat well. I think what kind of goes into that as well is I want to drink less. I feel like, I mean, especially when you're 23 and you live in New York City and you work for a consulting company, I feel like it's just like everything is just happy hour, happy hour, happy hour, happy hour, and then the weekends are like, let's go get drunk. And it's fun and all, but for me, I feel like it would just be so much better if I like took a step back. So I kind of want to just be healthy and maintain that, and I think within that, drink less and probably drink more water. I want to find cool things to go to, join some classes maybe, or like a weekly meetup or something like that, just to meet other cool like-minded people in the city. New York's totally the place where that can happen. I just gotta do some digging, that's all, but I'm sure there's a dime a dozen of events and meetups and all cool kinds of cool people. But I do want to take more classes, like acting classes, meet up with other cool like creators. Like, that would be fun. I don't know, maybe I'm really cheesy, but I think that that would be cool. Oh my god, of course my camera is dying. Okay, I think my final one for this year is I just want to be happy. I think people are always so fixated on I want to do this, 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 and this, and they forget the main thing. And I just want to be happy and healthy, and I hope my loved ones are happy and healthy, and that's all I can really ask for. So those are sort of my goals for 2020. I wish you all a very happy and healthy and prosperous 2020. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure you like it and subscribe if you aren't already. And here's to making way more content. Bye.